watching Let's Chat.
We had a lot of localized flooding a couple of weeks ago, and this may have affected you. And here's someone that you may need to call and talk to now. Eric, thanks for joining us with AFS Foundation and Water, but waterproofing. How about it? We can't repair water, can we?
We can't. When it's broke, it's broke.
All right. Well, Eric, thanks for joining us this morning. Tell us a little bit more about AFS.
AFS is a really interesting company, very, very unique. You know, first off, we're specialists. Mm-hmm. You know, rather than focusing on the general contracting industry and trying to be a jack of all trades, AFS is the best at what we do because we keep it narrow.
Perfect.
When it comes to foundation repair, when it comes to waterproofing, water intrusion in the house, whether you've got a basement or whether you've got a crawl space or whether you've got a slab, AFS is chosen by more homeowners dealing with those kinds of situations really than any other company in the Southeast.
That's great.
Yeah, and you know, we're a family-owned company.
Okay.
You know, just nearly 20 years ago, we started just out of a garage in Decatur, Alabama with Ben and Rachel Bayless. You know, with a marketing department that wasn't much more than handing out flyers in the Yellow Pages. And, you know, fast forward to today, we're in five locations, over 250 employees, and over 70,000 houses under warranty.
You've really grown into a multi-state business.
We really have.
We're going to talk about the foundation side of it here in just a minute.
Great.
But I think it's on everyone's mind because we did have that localized flooding a few weeks ago. You know, we're in a dry spell right now.
Right.
But the weather changes. When do we need to be thinking about, you know, our crawl space and our basements?
Right, right. You know, the answer is always now. Mm-hmm. You know, sooner than later. You know, one of the main challenges of living here in this kind of southeastern climate is the fact that we have a clay-based soil. Mm-hmm. And clay is highly expansive. You know, when clay is wet, it's going to expand. When clay is dry, it's going to contract. And every time it dries and contracts, it's going to change shape,
right,
which allows for water penetration to make a way into the house. And these problems, they don't fix themselves. Mm-hmm. And often they start out small, and they are, they're hard to see, they're hard to identify, but as they grow, the implications can really compound in terms of the structural integrity of the house, in terms of the health and the safety of, you know, your family and your home. So sooner than later is always a good thing.
Is there anything we can, you know, do or be looking for, you know, to prevent, you know, leaks and major flooding? Or is that one of those instances that it just, when it happens, we know we need help?
Sure. No, that's a great question. You know, AFS is a really easy company to work with, and all of our inspections are 100% free. So if you live here in the Southeast, there's no reason to not invite AFS to come out and check your property. And we get that all the time. People who don't even think they have a problem but just want to be sure. You know, a lot of people in this area have crawl spaces.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Most people don't enjoy entering their crawl spaces, which is...
Nope, you will not catch me in there.
Yeah, and I don't blame you. It's an out-of-sight, out-of-mind kind of thing. So a lot of the times, those problems will remain hidden. And they'll just compound, you know, month after month, year after year, until a plumber goes under there and all of a sudden says, hey, we got a huge problem. And, you know, little did you know, you've been living over a major moisture and mold issue for years and years and years and years. So, you know, simply calling AFS out just to take a look around your house, provide you with a free inspection, no expectations at all, is always a safe place to start.
So you can, anytime, I mean,
absolutely,
get routine. It's almost like going to the doctor
exactly,
for your house, right?
Exactly, exactly.
All right, so I want to talk about the foundation side a little bit. Obviously,
sure,
with the waterproofing, we know we have an issue when we have the leaks,
right,
and the flooding. Talk about the foundation. That creeps up on us a little bit more.
Yeah, so, you know, when a house is built, it's poured, the concrete footers are poured. And those concrete footers, you know, are installed wider than the foundation wall, and they're installed in a way that tries to displace the weight of that foundation wall over the soil.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the challenge is we have active soil zones, and the upper layers of that active soil zone oftentimes are really hard to control.
Mm-hmm.
So for lack of a better way to compare it, foundation footings often work a lot like a pontoon boat.
Makes sense.
You know, but when that foundation or when that soil beneath that footing starts to move, it doesn't take much movement to see that foundation footing start to crack. And, you know, last time I checked, concrete's not very flexible.
Right.
You know, so the fix oftentimes is getting in there with something we call the foundation pier. And we've got different applications for different situations. But that pier is going to be driven deep through those active soil zones.
Good.
And once they've gone through those active soil zones, we can we can establish a proper foundation in what engineers call load-bearing strata. And you know what we're actually seeing more and more commonly is people trying to prevent that from becoming a problem. So we've got more and more builders calling all the time and saying, hey, I know that this is something that's unavoidable in a lot of cases with traditional construction methods. So let's go ahead and install these while we're pouring the footers, so we know that these customers are never going to have to worry about foundation issues again.
But you're going to be able to help us either way, whether we just need a checkup to maybe do some preventative steps, or we already have those issues. Eric, how do we get started with AFS?
Well, the best way to get started is always online.
Perfect.
You know, you can visit us at afsrepair.com, or you can just go ahead and Google, you know, AFS Foundation and Waterproofing Experts, and we're going to be all over page one.
All right, AFSrepair.com. Of course, you can keep up with them on Facebook for some tips and tricks. Eric, thanks for joining us this morning. While we're in this dry spell, let's get it taken care of, right?
Absolutely.
All right, we'll talk to you again soon.
See ya.